Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to another practical video here at the Vaal University of Technology. And the subject is electronics. It's electronics 3. And the idea is to show you guys, give some guidance as to how to connect circuits for op-amps. We often see students not understanding this side of the circuit where they say plus 15 volts through the capacitor to ground and then on pin 4, which goes from minus 15 to ground. And what happens if you do it wrong, then you have an explosion, because these capacitors are electrolytic capacitors and they don't like to have the wrong polarity applied onto these circuits. Obviously there is some kind of a risk involved when we are building the circuits and applying the voltage, because these things, when it explodes, this metal cap comes out and there's a lot of smoke and some paper comes flying out of the component, and obviously that can injure you, possibly pop into your eyes or something like that. So we prefer you guys work safe. So what I've got here, two circuits. I'm specifically using the small breadboard just to prove to you that size doesn't matter and we can get away with a small breadboard. So recap on breadboard use, very important. Orientate the breadboard so that the plus is on top, the minus is at the bottom. Here's another plus sitting here and there's another minus sitting there, and when we use this circuit, we're actually going to consider using that to our advantage. Also, the two circuits that's given here are very simple. You should be able to identify them if you have done the subject. On the circuit on the left for 24.3, it is a non-inverting operational amplifier. On the circuit on the right, it's an inverting operational amplifier. So, non-inverting means we are using the positive input and getting the results. And inverting means we are using pin 2, which is a negative input, getting the results. Now in the textbooks, one often doesn't see these two capacitors or even a reference in terms of where is the supply going to be. Also from this circuit, you can notice that the IC itself, pin 1 is not used, pin 2 is used, 3 is used, 4 is for going to minus 15 volts. 5 is not used, 6 we use it as an output, 7 is plus 15, and then pin 8 is also not used. So there's two pins on this IC that we actually never use. And depending on which model you're using, you actually are never going to use it, unless you have a specialized op-amp which has got other features. That's not relevant to this circuit, but just keep in mind to always check your circuit when you're building it. So, what is special about this op-amp? It does not connect to ground. Look, the circuit connects to ground. The capacitor connects to ground. But the overall IC itself, none of the 8 pins is actually connected to ground. And that is how it is. The reason is we are using a positive negative voltage, and in one of our power supply videos, I'm showing you guys how to set up the power supply to be a split supply. And that allows me to have plus 15 ground at minus 15 as my power supply source. The same with the inverting amplifier, plus 15, minus 15, and ground is my source. So the output, in fact, is taken between the output voltage pin, pin 6, and ground. So the output actually sits across this resistor circuit here. On the inverting amplifier, there's nothing except for the feedback resistor connecting to ground. And even here, the feedback only goes back to pin 2, because we need the feedback in order for the amplifier to amplify. The feedback resistor here is a shared voltage divider going there, and on this side, no voltage divider, just simply going back and having the input resistance straight from the signal generator. So, we are focusing on how to construct the circuit on a breadboard. Plus is positive, so I'm going to use plus as my red wire, and negative is my ground. So that's two of my supply lines. Now in the lab, we usually have a very convenient setup where we actually use green just to be color coded, but green I usually use as my minus 15 line, and I encourage the students to do that because the power supply is set up so that it gives me ground, minus 15 and plus 15. So the breadboard can be set up in the same way, because now I'm using my three power rails on the breadboard to give me my three power sources that can be used. So let's start with the circuit, the non-inverting amplifier. So I choose a spot here on the breadboard, and keep in mind I'm now very conscientious in terms of showing that these circuits are very simple. You don't need to use the full size breadboard all the way just for a small circuit. If you do happen to own one of these, which usually comes with the Arduino kits, you're more than welcome to bring it and use it. The second circuit will set it up on this side. So what they do is the ICs are orientated so that, very important, so that pin 1 is at the bottom left hand side. Do not go upside down. If I read the text that is printed on this IC, I would like to read it as if I'm reading a book. Why the heck do I see students doing this? Or even worse, taking the IC and putting it upside down. There's just no logic to that. The thing is, if I do this, even the two orientations will be wrong. And we know that if we're going to do circuits and even on PC boards, we would like to orientate the components in a structured and organized way. So do not confuse your lab technician, because once you confuse that guy, he's going to deduct your marks and you're not going to get your marks for the practicals. So keep that in mind. We are very strict when it comes to the way that we use circuits. So I use two capacitors. Positive for this capacitor going to pin 7 must come down to ground. So because I know where my ground is the blue line here, I can now make a decision. Remember, I've got this top also a blue line that says minus. So nothing stops me from taking a jumper lead from blue to blue. So that's one way that you can successfully keep ground to be ground. Because we have to have a capacitor going from the top, which is pin 7, count them with me, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And the long leg of that capacitor must come to pin 15. The short leg can go to ground. So that's the way I do it. So my negative on the capacitor is to ground. The same on pin 4. Pin 4, now you must be careful. It is the positive, look at my symbol, the straight line is positive, that goes to ground. So it means capacitor must sit like that, according to the long leg, short leg rule. Or if I have the minus of the capacitor, that means the minus this side, it must also orientate itself in that way. So the minus towards the IC, the plus going to ground. So it's opposite of the previous capacitor. So plus going to ground, minus going to pin 4. And if I do it like this, and I let it show you guys, then you've done that capacitor, and now we need to connect pin 4 to 15 volt. So again, I use a very convenient piece of wire. So pin 4 must now go to this bottom red, we said that is minus 15. So I go like that, the blue wire in this case, I use it like so. And then pin 7, according to the circuit, pin 7 must go to plus 15, which means the top red line. My two red lines are not connected, The one is minus 15 at the bottom, and the top is plus 15 volts. That gives us a split supply. So, now I've got my power connections sorted. Then they ask us V-in. V-in will be on pin number 3. Pin number 3 is going here. And I can just stick it in here. Or I can bring a probe from the instrument and connect it to the breadboard. It doesn't matter. And then I have pin 2, which needs two resistors. So now, to do the two resistors, that's a 1K and a 10K. The 1K comes from ground to pin 2. Ground, which is the blue line at the bottom, to pin number 2. Notice I don't use extra wires for that because it's not needed, but the 1K connecting ground to pin 2 and a 10K that is now connecting from pin 6. Pin 6 is here, going also to pin 2. So a bit of finger magic. You can see that one at the bottom is connected, that one is connected. Alright, awesome. So to recap, plus, minus, I jumped the ground to minus or the zero volt to the top blue line as well. I make sure of the orientation of the capacitors, because if the capacitors are orientated correctly, there will not be smoke and fire and brimstone, the circuit will work. And through a bit of wiring and so on, I can actually make sure the connections are fine. The output is taken here on this resistor, because the scope lead that we're going to connect, they can connect straight here. Alternatively, you could have also used now an output wire on the yellow one, for instance. Take it to a place that is convenient and make your connections there. I prefer not to do it because I have an exposed connection there. It's just pin 3 that is very creative, so I would like to have a wire coming out, because where the heck are you going to connect it? So that is how you connect it. Let's do the second circuit. Second circuit can be also very straightforward. What is the orientation of the capacitor? In this case, like this, long leg towards plus, short leg towards ground. So I can opt to use it like before, or, and I'll show you the problem with not doing it that way, I can take the long leg, put it on pin 7, but now I have to stretch all the way down to the ground at the bottom, like so. And that makes it difficult or impractical to have other components being connected here. For that reason, I like to use the ground on top for this practical. So I swap that. I swing the capacitor around, make sure the short leg goes into the 0 volt line, which is the blue line on my breadboard. And the second capacitor, then the positive towards ground, and number 4 then becomes my minus VCC. So I can then do that. I can now connect that one like we did before, and connect this one here, pin number 4 going to the red at the bottom, which is my green from the power supply, minus 15, and lastly the two resistors. Now the circuit is very simple, pin 6 to pin 2, must have a 10 kilo ohm resistor. Again, I can just simply put the resistor jumping from pin 6 to pin 2, voila, and then the 10 or the 1 kilo ohm goes there towards the input, and I can plug it in here, pin 2 going to some point where it's convenient, and pin number 3 I can then take it from here and connect it to ground, because number 3 must be grounded like a naughty boy. Okay, and that's it. To recap, I can do both circuits on one breadboard. Even a half a breadboard is fine. I can have my power supply red, plus 15, black, 0 volts or ground, and green, I can make it minus 15. I can use the breadboard to its full advantage, and when I'm done, my circuit actually represents the type of circuit that we have in a schematic. And if you do that, and if you do this method, you are guaranteed to get a high mark, and also to have a circuit that's going to function the moment you switch it on. If you do not do this, if you orientate your components in another way, confusion will come, the technician will be confused, and you are going to lose marks. This is the proper way of using a breadboard, and if you don't use this method, we are going to penalize you in the practical lab. With that, I see you in the lab. Let's see how the circuits work. Thank you very much.